So if you know Ski or Sky or whatever you want to call it, well, it's one of those games that was actually one of the first PC games, I think. And yeah, you just have to pay your respects to some of the first games that appeared on the PC. And besides, I think this is one of the games so many people played. Yeah, I think this was a very popular game because it was easy and silly, but let's just start. As you can see, you don't have a lot of controls. You have the option to play with mouse, keyboard or controller. And it will be exactly what you expect, a very simple and fun little game. Now this costs about 2 euros or about $3. So yeah, you have to get all the flags and get a lot of points and avoid the rocks. You also have a lot of camera modes, and by a lot I mean 3. This is the classic one. Ouch, well at least the Yeti didn't get me. I don't know how I played this game with a classic camera. Well, it's a little faster than the original, that's for sure. But yeah, the only point of the game is to get a high score. We also have a first person camera, which is exactly as it sounds, extremely silly. I don't know what he's doing with... Ouchie? Let's try that again. I don't know what he's doing... Oh, that's his scarf in the wind. Now we can do some tricks. We don't die if we hit that, but we crash if we hit the dogs or the snowboarders or the Yetis. Kind of hard to learn it, but yeah. First person Yeti. That was kind of unlucky. Okay, let's play this the normal way and let's see what we can do. If you do some tricks, there is you don't gain anything from them. The music is also kind of interesting. Oops. Okay, let's try to get a high score. As you can see, I'm very rusty in the game. Okay. We can do some tricks when we jump. No? Okay, let's let the Yeti get us. Oh, the Yeti is so happy when he gets us. In the original Ski, you actually get eaten by the Yeti if he catches you. So I guess this one is a little toned down. And you know, we don't have a lot of great games for kids or for, you know, people who just want to have fun without being very, very angry at the game. So yeah, this is kind of like the perfect game. Besides it, you can play it for 5 minutes, you can play it for 10 minutes, you can play it for 1000 minutes at a time. I mean, you do have some achievements for a high score, so... Yeah, you can also work on getting those. Other than that, it's a very simple game, but it's exactly what I needed. Some nostalgia is always... What? The Yeti stole my... my race. Okay, let's focus a bit here. Okay. Okay, it's okay. We're fine. Oh, that dog is so hidden over there. Okay, we can make it. By the way, you can bypass all the ice stuff. And yeah, it does get harder and harder, so don't worry. See? We almost hit that guy. Hey, the Yeti knew exactly where I was going, so even though I saw him. Yeah, sometimes it's just good to play one of those older games that you played when you were younger. Or even as an adult. Easy now, easy. You also get the nice dodge thing if you avoid the tree. Oh. And by the way, this is still a very hard game if you want to, you know, get the high score and the achievement for it. Okay, that was a very interesting dodge we did. Okay, let's avoid the nonsense. Ouch, what was that? Come on, we can do better than this. Let's at least try it. Yeah, for the price it's actually very fun and it's, you know, nostalgia games, I love them. Besides, lately I've been watching the retro... I've been watching a retro gaming channel on Twitch. Actually, I've been watching a lot of retro gaming on Twitch because even though those games are very old, they are still very fun, as opposed to most games that we play today. Yeah, they actually felt challenging and hard, and you know, those games are easy to play, easy to have fun, but very hard to master, like this one. Easy to play, easy to have fun, but so hard to master it. Get away from Yeti, it's not dinner time yet. And besides, this game was made in Unity, so it's kind of beautiful with all the snowflakes and help? No! Well, I was eaten by two Yetis, that's a crowd. So yeah, I need to practice more. I definitely will play more of it off camera. Okay. The Yetis are very aggressive in this one, it appears. Let's avoid the tree. Okay, we didn't die. Those are good points. Oh, come on, Yeti. Why do you always do this to me? So if the Yeti catches you while you are on a ramp, well, you can't change your direction mid-air. Easy. Okay, we're learning. Hey, I missed the dog. I didn't hit the dog. Oh, the game is so ruthless. Okay, let's play this for a few more minutes because I'm enjoying it. I think the first time I played it, it was not even my computer. And I was impressed by how fun the game can be even though it's so simple. I didn't even understand what was going on. But yeah, when you have a basic game that is actually kind of interesting, has the Yeti as a, you know, another element of fun, it's kind of interesting. Okay, let's see if we can get further. I'll try to avoid all the flags and all the traps like that. Because I want to show you how hard it can be later on. And later on you'll actually encounter more of the snowboarder guys and some other obstacles. What? How? This is so annoying. The Yeti is so vicious. I mean, when I played off camera, he never did that. Okay, the Yeti is actually winning all the games now. Ah, missed me. And he'll actually chase you, so you have to be careful, you don't get caught. Okay, let's not do that, because that's so dangerous. Yeah, you have to have some good reactions in this game. Ooh. Okay. Okay. Hey, where did you come from yet? I didn't even see you. Yeah, we avoided the fence, we avoided every obstacle so far. So yeah, this is the round that will actually have the most points for me. And after this I'll end the video because it's a fun game, but I can't play it all day. Or maybe I can play it all day, but yeah. So many things to do. Yeah, this is a good one. Oh, I'm starting to learn. Okay, the snowboarder guy hit me. High score, decent one. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.